Sprites are the heart and soul of Game Boy games. They are used for characters, enemies, bullets, special effects, and more. In a previous tutorial, I showed you how to draw a background. In this tutorial, we'll draw basic sprites on the screen. Sprites in Game Boy games are drawn over both the background and window tile maps. They can be moved freely, independent of one another, and can even be flipped around. Game Boy games support up to 40 different sprites in 2 different sizes. A sprite can be 8x8, the size of a single tile, or a sprite can be 8x16, the size of 2 tiles stacked vertically. We'll start this tutorial by copying our minimal template provided by the GBDK. If you don't have the GBDK installed, check out the previous video on getting started with GBDK. Once we've cloned that folder, we need our sprite source files. Check out the video description for a link to the sprite files used in this tutorial. I'll also include a .vscode folder. If you install the C++ extension for the Visual Studio Code, you can use IntelliSense when coding your Game Boy games. Drawing sprites can be broken down into 4 different steps. Include the sprites into our compilation process in code files. Add the sprite tile data into VRAM. Enabling sprites on the Game Boy, and finally showing the sprite. In this tutorial, we've cloned the minimal template. Its makefile automatically includes all .c files into compilation. So all we need to do next is include the header file for our sprite. Like with drawing backgrounds, before we can draw a sprite, we need to set its tile data into VRAM. For drawing backgrounds, we use the setBKGData function. To put sprite tile data into VRAM, we'll use the setSpriteData function. We'll use 0 as the first parameter. This is where our tiles will begin in the region of VRAM dedicated to sprites. The second parameter will be how many tiles are in our circle sprites graphic. Our third and final parameter will be a pointer to the circle sprites tile data. The Game Boy supports up to 40 different sprites. Once we've set the tile data in VRAM, we can use the setSpriteTile function to assign a tile to the sprite. This function takes in 2 parameters, which sprite you want to use, and what tile should that sprite show. In this case, to keep things simple, we'll use Sprite 0 and Tile 0. The last thing to do is move the sprite to a visible location. For that, we have a function conveniently named MoveSprite. This function takes 3 parameters: the index of the sprite we want to move, the X position we want to move to, and the Y position we want to move to. We'll move our sprite to the coordinate 80, 80. However, one important thing to note, Game Boy sprites are drawn with a negative offset. Whatever location you want the top left corner of the sprite to actually be at, you need to add 8 pixels to the X position and 16 pixels to the Y position. This means a sprite positioned at 00 will not be visible on screen. Now that our sprite is in a visible location, we need to make sure the Game Boy actually renders sprites. By default, sprites will not be rendered. We have to explicitly tell the Game Boy to actually show sprites using the Show Sprites macro. We only need to do this once. Now any sprites we use will be visible. Finally, before we test, I'm going to show off the scroll sprite function. This function changes the sprite's location like the move sprite function. However, the scroll sprite function changes the sprite's position relative to its current location. If we compile and run our ROM file, we should see our sprite moving across the screen. That's cool, but one more feature I need to cover in this video is drawing 8x16 sprites. By default, sprites are 8x8. The size of a single tile. If we add the sprites 8x16 macro to our code, now all sprites will be 8x16. When this mode is enabled, for whatever tile we assign a single sprite, without costing any extra sprites, the Game Boy will automatically draw the next tile in VRAM immediately below it. If we recompile our ROM file, we should see now our sprite has 2 circle tiles moving across the screen. Before I end this video, I'll just mention a useful feature that I'll make a future video on. Often, multiple sprites are used to make up a single object. These are called Metasprites, and they are a supported GBDK feature. The GBDK implementation of Metasprites makes it easier to draw, animate, and move larger objects. In a later video, I'll show you how to actually use Metasprites. I hope you found this video helpful. As always, if you need help, reach out in the comments or in the GBDK Discord server. Like and subscribe for more Game Boy game development videos. Have a good day.